An $11,000 fine, even jail time. That's the brutal threat to anyone heading south of the border if they break the new rules to keep COVID out of our state. The government is talking tough after a new explosion of cases in Victoria. But as you're about to see, actually policing our borders is another matter altogether.
While the virus continues to run rampant in Melbourne, at Sydney Airport, not a single passenger is being asked where they're from or where they've been.
We thought that they might look at our licence in regards to the postcodes, because 10 postcodes have been locked down, but no.
Nothing as well. Straight down, straight out.
14 flights from Melbourne landed in Sydney today. Thousands of people hopping off planes. No questions asked.
I was expecting people to be everywhere. Government to be everywhere, checking everybody, even temperatures coming through, but there was nothing.
73 new infections in Victoria in 24 hours, more than 300 in 5 days. Yet, in our city, there's no border control.
You get checked when you go to discount chemist warehouse, you know, and you don't get checked at the airport.
Victoria's spike is now rivaling the worst of the pandemic in late March. A big chunk of Melbourne now preparing to be locked down tonight.
It's kind of like going in the last 2 weeks to a wedding followed by a funeral.
I wanted to cry, if I'm completely honest.
While there's no enforcement, people in Melbourne hotspots are being threatened with jail time if they try and flee north.
If you are found here in New South Wales, you face very heavy penalties, so don't come.
If you are a Victorian and live or have been in a hotspot, you will not be able to enter New South Wales. If you do and are caught, the penalty is an $11,000 fine or 6 months jail. If you are a resident of New South Wales and try to come back after visiting a Melbourne hotspot, you will be ordered to stay at home for 14 days. If you refuse, you will face the same penalties.
Don't go to Victorian hotspots. Just don't go.
But there won't be official checkpoints at the road border or airport.
This is a balancing act, you know, in terms of the risk.
Gladys Berejiklian is banking on Victoria's suburban lockdowns to contain the risk. The idea is, if you can't leave your home in Melbourne, you can't travel to Sydney. And there are still no plans to shut the state border.
There's never been a national cabinet decision to have internal borders. That was never the medical expert advice.
Instead of adding to our quarantine hotels, almost all of the 67 international flights scheduled for Melbourne over the next fortnight have been cancelled. Australians who now have to find another way home. Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.
OK, let's bring in Mark Burrows in the studio. Mark, there's been a development with the virus outbreak at Newmarch House.
Peter, 19 elderly residents died at Anglicare's Newmarch House. It was one of the deadliest outbreaks in the country. Families say they want answers, and so with Shine lawyers. Some are in the first stages of mounting a class action against Anglicare. Shine is alleging the operators were negligent and breached a duty of care. Shine says grieving relatives want to know why their loved ones weren't immediately taken to hospital after testing positive. Any class action will need at least 7 people to join the claim. Given that 19 died, that would not appear to be an impediment. Peter.
Mark, thank you. Our state took another big step out of lockdown today. The rules relaxed again on where you can go and how you can get there.
Sydney's transport network shifting up a gear. Buses, trains, trams and ferries rolling into day one of stage three's relaxed restrictions.
This is the first time I've been in a couple of weeks and, yeah, look, it was a lot busier.
Capacity limits doubled, Sydney lurching back to life and with it, the economy.
It's a great day here in New South Wales, and it's because the community has done such a fantastic job.
Reaping the rewards of months of good behaviour, restaurants and cafes, pubs and clubs, even function centres. Now they can hold any number of people as long as they stick to the 1 person per 4 square metre rule.
The 550 staff that we have on board are all very excited to be back at work.
I just think it just brings joy and happiness to a lot of people, you know, and I think it stimulates the economy a bit again.
Lifting the curtain in time for the school holidays, cinemas, theme parks and theatres, and the number of fans allowed into stadiums boosted by 25%. Come Friday, here in Parramatta, up to 10,000 people will now be able to stream into the stadium to watch the Eels take on the North Queensland Cowboys. But cash will no longer be king. You'll need to use PayWave to purchase your pies and your hot chips. As for gaining access to the venue, all tickets will be electronic.
And with community sport kicking off, shaking off those pandemic shackles has never felt so good.
We're super stoked to get back to it. Jiu-jitsu, health, fitness, it's such a massive part of people's well-being.
Ellie Walsh, Nine News.